Please welcome back Michael Anderson.
Well, grace and peace to you, my friends. I've had the privilege of knowing Doug the last 14 years. He actually had three other pastors in his life as well. See, God wanted to keep his eye on Doug. He didn't know he was quite a character and a rascal. But family asked me to share a few thoughts about Doug and my relationship with him. I thought about Doug, and I thought about a Bible verse that would be most fitting, or actually a character of Bible that would be most fitting and indicative of who the man that Doug was. So I picked a gentleman named King David from the Old Testament. He was the greatest king of all of Israel. The Bible says one thing about him that made him a great king. It says David was a man after God's own heart. Doug Fischer was a man after God's own heart. I had the joy of watching Doug as our choir director. Our choir sings at the 8 a.m. service in the morning, and they practice before the service. So Doug and I were always two of the first people at church. And I never remember a Sunday where Doug wasn't brimming with excitement, full of energy and looking dapper in a sharp suit. Right, choir? Give me an amen out there.
Amen.
He was always ready to go. And I always asked him where he got his morning coffee, because I wanted some of that energy for my message as well. Doug was passionate for the choir, and they absolutely loved him. He was a leader and a good friend. He was fun, but he also knew when to get down to business. Doug led boldly in the choir and musician spotlight. I always remember the special Christmas choir concerts and the special performances on Easter and Christmas with brass. You could feel the Holy Spirit resonate during those services, and it literally gave you chills under Doug's servant leadership. Doug was the choir director after God's own heart. I know Doug had quite a bit of passion. His dad David couldn't be here, and his mom Margie, but David was quite a composer in his own right. I'm so proud of Doug. Doug was always caring and loving for his parents. Every Sunday they went out to get a bite to eat at Panera. Doug is so faithful to his parents. He honored the fourth commandment. He honored his father and mother, and it went well with him all his days. Doug was a son after God's own heart. Doug was a loving brother to his sister Leslie. They supported each other through thick and thin. Doug was a brother after God's own heart. Doug and I talked about sports quite a bit, as you know, he's kind of a sports fan. And we also talked about our kids a lot. His kids were older than my kids. And we talked a lot about my son, who's playing football for Woodbridge. Yes, he plays for the Woodbridge Warriors. I think he played a game this year in football. I'm not sure what happened, but maybe someone can let me know after the service. Hey, but the Beckman band rocked it out. They were fantastic. So we talked about our kids, and Doug would fill me in on Sean and Holly, and talk about Sean played baseball and hit it out of the park. And he said, you're going to love this baseball match on your son. You're out there rooting for your son. And he always spoke with such pride about both Sean and Holly. He was a father. As a father, he was a man after God's own heart. Finally, I got to see Doug's relationship with Lori. They so perfectly complemented each other. Doug with his big, charismatic personality, and Lori with her steady, gentle, and sweet spirit. I developed a new appreciation for the depth and quiet strength of Lori, and her deep, abiding faith in the Lord during the period after Doug's death. She displayed, unbelievably so, been a pastor for 22 years, she displayed grace, love, and a deep, abiding faith in the Lord. Doug was a husband after God's own heart. Doug, I'm really going to miss you, buddy. Sunday mornings will never be the same without your joy and passion. But I know you're busy in heaven, directing something